sometimes patients, when they go to consultants, can't get enough services on a diagnosis, say, kid has a Down syndrome, and they'll add to it autism, even though the kid doesn't have it. Not that they're trying to do anything wrong, they're trying to do something right. They can't get the services covered the kid needs, so they have to shift the diagnosis. You know, you could probably put anything under that spectrum, you can find some component.
Right.
You see that happening more and more?
I see it happening every day. I am writing, I'd say, at least one or two letters a week for parents who are trying to get really genuinely needed services for a child, and there's all this bureaucracy. And, you know, they created these individual educational plans and 504 plans a few years ago, and I thought that was going to help a lot, but I'm finding that it's actually created another roadblock, because now there has to be this formal meeting, formal diagnoses. You have to basically hit certain qualifications. So it's, in some ways, it's meant to do well, but I find it puts up a lot of bureaucracy. And yes, then now we have to, the tail wags the dog. Now the clinician has to come up with a diagnosis that'll get the kid the services.